Guys, now we have to take out the motherboard and we are using T5 screwdriver. We have to remove everything on the top to connect the keyboard. And after that, we need to remove the battery also because we have also to replace the trackpad. But before you can remove the battery, you should remove first the, these are the speakers. Make sure you sort your screws like this. You should have this magnetic project mat to make it easier for you to find the right screw. Remove the Wi-Fi antenna. And take out the Wi-Fi or I/O port. Then remove the battery. Now what we have to do is we'll replace the trackpad first. On the trackpad, we have to use the T4 screwdriver. It means Torx 4 screwdriver. Remove all these screws. To take out this plate, metal plate above the trackpad. And then we will use again the T5, it means the Torx 5 screwdriver, to remove the trackpad. As you can see, you need to remove all the surrounding screws here. These are too much screws. I don't know why they put too much. And now take it out, the trackpad. Just push from the bottom and then take it out. Now I have to replace this one. As you can see, this is burnt and have too much liquid. We cannot fix this one. I tried already replacing the ICs, but still the same. So we have to replace this one. And I have the new one. This is the new trackpad I have. I ordered it from China. I hope it is the same. Yeah, this is the same trackpad. Now we have to install it. By the way, this MacBook liquid damage, it came to me like 3 days ago, and obviously I already checked the trackpad and I tried to fix it, but I cannot fix it. So I ordered the trackpad. Then we have to install it. But I did not remove the keyboard before, so this is still intact, the original one. But we have also to replace this one. I have the new one also. So now we have to return all the screws that we removed. When you are fixing like this device that have too much screws, you need a sorting mat, like a sorting project mat, just to sort all of your screws so that you don't have to find every time you put it back. And it is much easier to to put it back, because all of the screws are sorted already. And you don't have to worry that it will be interchanged. Just return all screws. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Don't remove this one now, because we will remove this one later. The sticker. Now we have to replace also the keyboard. So we need to remove the keyboard. This is the keyboard backlight, so I think it's still okay. So we have to return this one after. Now you have to remove all these screws. I don't know why Apple make like this. They put too much screws on the keyboard, and it will be taking too much time to remove it. As you can see, I already removed all the screws from the keyboard, and I think there's still one screw left. Whew, too much screws. Yeah. After you remove all the screws, then you have to lift it up like this. This is a liquid damage keyboard, and it's not working. As you can see, there's some liquid here. Now you guys, before you replace the keyboard or you order the keyboard, you should check the compatibility, like this one. It should be the same, because the top case, you see the enter key, The top case also is the same as this. Yeah. So if you, I will show you some another people. Guys, this keyboard is for MacBook Pro A1278, but I'll just show you the different interface. See, this interface design like this, and this one like this. So you should be careful about this thing, because before I ordered the keyboard and I did not notice it's like this. So you should check first the top case, the keyboard. Now we have to replace the keyboard. Just clean this one. I have the new keyboard backlight here, but I think I will use the old one. I think it is much better than this. The quality. Of course, it's old, but the quality, I think it is much durable, and it is much the lighting is good. So it means I will use this one. So now we have to we will put the keyboard and yeah, like this. We will put a screw in the center. Oops. On the sides. And after that, you have to check the alignment. Yeah, it's good. I think it's good. Yeah, sometimes there are some like case. Not aligned to the top case, so you have to check before you put all the screws. Also guys, you have to be very careful about this, like this one. There's a screw hole, but there's a flex cable coming right through to the screw hole. See? If you put the screw here, it will be, the flex cable will be damaged. So, just don't put a screw. It is not necessary to put a screw, because there's too much screw on this keyboard. So just be careful. All the flex cable that you can see on the screw holes, just don't put a screw. Okay guys, I already put all the screws. You have to check here if there's some. Some case not properly locked. Now, of course, I did not put all the screws. It's too many. It's killing my time. So now we have to return the backlight. Keyboard backlight. Just make sure all these things came out like this. All this. Because you have to put screws on these things later when you put the motherboard back. What is this thing? So now we have to put the motherboard back. But first we have to return this Wi-Fi or input-output board. Now we have to put all this. These are Wi-Fi antennas. Don't forget this one, because there will be no signal on your Wi-Fi after if you forget this one. So now we will put the motherboard back. If you put the motherboard back, you should make sure this all these wires are at the top. It's hard to remove again the screws when it's inside. I mean, it's not hard, but you have to remove all the screws again and then take out the cables. you should return all the screws the motherboard, because these are important. This is the backlight keyboard backlight connector. You should return this one, or else there will be no backlight on your keyboard. This is the LCD connector. It's charging port connector. And this one. What is this thing? This cable. I think this is for the sensor. I think this is a mic sensor. Yeah, I think so. So after all that, then we have to return the battery. Where's the battery? Obviously, guys, when you remove the battery for the first time, it will be not easy to remove, you know, because there's a lot of adhesive here, so it means I already removed it before. That's why it is easy for me to remove. But of course, I forgot something. We need to put this plate back. Is it right? I'll connect the keyboard and this one we will put the plate above. Make sure to lock it. Then we will put this plate back like this. It's okay to forget something, but you have to check it, because put it there, it means it is useful. I think this one only a cover for the trackpad. Or maybe when you spill liquid on the trackpad, it will not come in, but I don't know what was the use of this one. Or maybe magnetic shield. Of course, you have to return all the screws. You should not miss something. Now we have to return the battery. And now we have to return this speaker. This speaker also lock the side of the battery in so that it will not be moving like this. Return all the screws as usual. Don't forget Now you have to remove this one so that it will not be moving it will not be moving inside while you're carrying the laptop. These guys make a long table. But it's okay. As long as it is working, it's okay. Now, put the battery back. Yeah, I think it's all complete. We have to try it if it's working. And now, guys, moment of truth. Cheers. Now we will test the trackpad. Trackpad, yeah, it's working. And keyboard. Oops. Yeah, it's just working fine. So that's all. This device, I have to replace the U800 because after I replace the keyboard and trackpad, it is not working. It's new, but it's not working. So I replace this. And I saw it is like this. You see? Oh, so many. It's very small, but the problem is power. And at least now it's working fine, and also the trackpad is working.